Good evening, everybody, and thank you for joining us tonight. As a coastal state, of course, we're always in somewhat jeopardy here, but according to a new comprehensive climate change study from the United Nations, could be worse.
In a story that's new at 10, Sam Spangler spoke to our city leaders today about their plan moving forward. Sam joins us now with more. Hey, Sam.
Lauren, the UN report from 100 international experts used 7,000 studies. It estimates massive sea level rises as well as fish and coral reef deaths. The city says it's more than a year ahead of the curve with its own research and is planning to reduce carbon use while adapting to future changes. According to the study, unless humans drastically reduce greenhouse gas emissions, sea levels could rise by 3 feet in the year 2100. And up to 17 feet by the year 2300, estimates that the city had also recently found.
That's reaffirming for me that the science is correct, our science is correct. It's showing a much more rapid rise in sea level.
One step is reducing carbon emissions. The city announced today they've converted all but 70 of Oahu's 53,000 streetlights to LEDs, reducing energy use by 60% and saving $5 million annually.
So it's a huge reducer for carbon pollution, which is great. I have over 300,000 tons of carbon, reduced by the new technology.
Another is withstanding future environmental impacts, floods, hurricanes, and wildfires, among others. One example, rail platforms have been risen by 6 feet.
Our vision is really, how can we make sure that the places where we've got a ton of public infrastructure and investment, we're able to armor and harden and make sure that, those can withstand. And then in other places, we may have to be flexible.
Some island nations have been encouraged to build sea walls.
We may have to look at how do we sort of allow the shoreline to move, allow the beach to live, because when you put up walls, you lose the beach. It's a death knell for beaches to put up walls.
Officials say public policy must be combined with personal responsibility.
Buy local ag, make sure that your transportation is as zero carbon as possible, and make sure that your home, you're reducing your energy load and then getting renewable on your home.
I think at the end of the day, it's transportation. That's the biggest emitter of carbon into our atmosphere, and it's a huge challenge.
Now, as far as what that would look like here, the Honolulu Climate Change Commission said in 2018 that a sea level rise of 3.2 feet would cause $12.5 billion in structure and land loss locally and displace over 13,000 Honolulu residents. Lauren, back to you.